All hail our Amazon overlords providing everything for us, apparently. Oh, Amazon.
It's not good, but I'm still going to buy it, you know?
Amazon disappointed me yesterday, though. Let me tell you. All right? They gaslighted me. So I ordered some Muscle Milk. I order my Muscle Milk off of Amazon. And I received it in the mail, opened it up. It was chocolate Muscle Milk. Vanilla is the only kind of Muscle Milk I order. Oh my goodness. And I'm like, wait, did I mess up? No, because I clicked on order I just repeated the order that I've already always ordered like every once a month or so. And so I look at it, sure enough, I ordered vanilla. They sent me chocolate!
Must have got mixed up somehow.
Bruh. Anyway, I will say though, I did the return order option, and they said they'll do a refund, and it also said no need to send the items back. So now I just have chocolate Muscle Milk sitting in my refrigerator, probably not getting consumed. But now I have to order more Muscle Milk, and I'm going to be running real low on Muscle Milk until I get more.
Jesus, I finally got over this stupid first obstacle and I fell on my face.
I'm sorry. This actually is kind of difficult here, this next one. What the heck? It's like the hitbox of this table is not what you think it's going to be. There we go. That's what I like to see. There we go. Maybe the tables have turned. Again.
Now the turntables turn.
Now the turns have tabled. Yeah, see, this table right here, dude, is weird hitboxy. Weird hitbox. You like think it's going to be there, but then it's not. And okay, you made it. That's cool too.
Yeah.
I wish you didn't do that. I don't know what's happening there though.
Why?
What are you doing?
I'm trying to break on top of it, but it's not working so well.
It's going to be a close one. Uh-oh. Oh no.
Was it right there? Was that
you
the
were,
end?
You should have had that. Yeah. Oh. That was real close.
Stairs are my enemy. My mortal enemy.
I'm sorry that's happened to you.
Was there Thai food?
One more tofu. Yeah. It was a really, really just short, simple one. Basically, you know how the new iPhone, well, it's not new at this point, but like the latest iPhone software has that measure, like VR measuring thing or AR measuring thing. Like you can point the phone at a room and it'll
not know about that. But
oh, okay. You can point the phone at a room and it'll like approximate measuring the sides and stuff like that. So he was like, huh, wouldn't it be interesting if I use the phone's app to measure something that men like to measure every now and again? So anyway, he was like in the bathroom doing it and oh, that was the finish. He's in the bathroom, nice. And his wife walks in, and it just looks like he's taking pictures, because he's, you know, just pointing the phone down there, and so his wife seemed to have thought he was taking photos, and he's like, I swear to God, I was not, like, taking photos to send to anyone, and so he sent her a photo of his member with the measuring AR on it.
Oh, does it, like, project, like, a ruler
yes,
on top?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. What does it look like? Because I'm imagining like the Fallout.
Actually,
Bat
I don't.
System.
All I remember was seeing it at the Apple presentation, but I haven't used it myself because I've not updated to the like. I think it's 12 that you need to have for it.
Ew, iPhones.
Come on. Now, please. I don't. Android might have a thing that does that as well. I have no idea.
I'm not aware of that.
Oh, okay.
I mean, it sounds kind of interesting, but like, how often would I really use something?
I mean,
like
it's
that?
Actually kind of. It's not bad because
I mean,
like,
whenever I need like a tape measure,
if you're
maybe.
If you're eyeballing, say you're like at somewhere, and
yeah, like,
you like you haven't measured. Yeah. Say it's like you're somewhere and just spur of the moment, you need to kind of think if something's gonna fit in your house, and so you can use that and kind of measure the thing, even though you don't have a tape measure on your hand. Then you can go back to your house and you can measure your house and be like, oh, okay, so it will fit or it won't fit.
I'm sure it's the kind of thing where it seems like not having it, I'm like, That doesn't really seem that.
It's probably like, useful, it's. But like, it doesn't matter until you need it. Yeah.
Yeah. Until then, I'd have it, and then I'd be like, oh, that's great that I have that. Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Why do you need your phone to do anything but just text? That's basically what I said. I was like.
I mean, there are definitely plenty of things that have been implemented on phones that are like, in the past, why would you ever need your phone to do this? And now it's probably like, oh yeah, that's helpful. It's good to have as an option. Yes, we do need a phone that has 5 cameras though. Right now it's only 4, and I think we need 5, personally. Oh wait, are there 2 on the front though? Because there are 3 on the back. IPhone? Yeah, are there 2 on the front? Does it actually have 5 cameras?
It might be. I don't know about the iPhone. It might be 4.
Because there's 3 on the back.
There might be a second front-facing camera. Because sometimes they're more so used for other stuff rather than taking pictures.
Hmm.
Like being a light sensor.
Uh huh.
So you it, like automatically changes your brightness and stuff like that.
Right. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. This is steep.
I'm waiting for my Pixel 4 to show up from Verizon, and it's taken about 3 weeks.
Wow.
But apparently that thing has like 8 sensors on the top of it.
For what?
It has like a radar sensor for like your hand motions.
For just making sure that the police aren't pointing radar at your car, radar detector.
Oh, yeah.
It'll tell you when you need to slow down. That'd be cool. Just mount. Yeah, that'd be actually really cool, dude. You have like a K-band radar sensor in your phone, so you can have, you know, how you have the navigation mount for your phone, like mount or the mount, so you can like look at navigation for your phone in your car. It also acts as like a radar detector. That'd be pretty cool.
Why? So you could do criminal activity, Jordan?
No, for your own education, just so you can analyze the patterns of how the police.
So you can
establish
speed limits.
No, so that you can analyze how the police. What's it like spread apart so that they can try to do their
so that you can make your car go vroom vroom fast, Jordan?
Never do that, dude. I think I might. I can't tell if I'm going to be getting a ticket in the mail. There's this one intersection. You've probably driven by it at some point. It's at Sunset and Hillcrest. Like right as you're, you know, it's like right in Beverly Hills to the slightly west of West Hollywood. And it is a completely broken speed camera. Or not a speed camera, it's just like a red light camera or something. It flashes every single time anyone goes through on an orange light. Every time I go through that, every time I'm at that intersection, if I witness an orange light, like say the light's turning red and I'm behind someone, it always flashes on anyone who goes through the orange. It doesn't matter how legal, how anything. It is so broken. So it flashed on me the other day as I was going through an orange, and I'm like, all right, well, are we going to get something? I've so far not gotten hit by that camera before, but it, like, I don't know what the deal is with that thing. It's ridiculous.
I've definitely gotten a ticket from some intersection on Sunset, so maybe that was it.
Really?
Yeah.
That's the only intersection on Sunset that has a camera, I think, so maybe it was that. God dang it, really?
I think it might have been.
What was it for?
I mean, I was actually at fault because the light went red and I was like in the crosswalk. So I was technically.
Like you were in the close crosswalk, not the far
maybe
crosswalk?
Maybe I was like a little over into the intersection. Like I was definitely.
But you were
some
like
sort of
at the start of the intersection crosswalk, not the end of the intersection. Because if you are.
I think I might have been into the actual intersection a little bit.
If you are in the intersection.
Because it was one of those like bumper to bumper where it's like, I don't know if I'm going to be able to make it in. Like, you know, like when the light is still green.
So it's not
like
you were running a light.
No, it was like I was kind of just like inching forward because I thought, you know.
Yeah, traffic gets backed up real badly there sometimes.
It happens in so many like intersections where you're just like. Okay, am I going to be able to make it? Like, are the people in front of me going to go forward?
Yep.
I don't know.
Oh, no, I know.
And then
I know.
You just get stuck, and then you're hanging
out
in the intersection like a dick.
It's a rough life. Yeah, well, okay, so if you are in the intersection, like, assuming traffic is flowing normally, if you're in the intersection during orange, yellow light, whatever color you guys want to call it, amber light, some of you were saying, you're free to.
Is that a debate going on right now?
I guess they're just people in different countries call it a different thing, so they're just.
I say yellow.
yellow, orange, whatevs, whatevs. You knew what I meant.
I didn't.
Okay, cool.
I thought it was a whole different light. I don't know.
Of course, of course. You're like, what?
It's colorblind? I've never heard of this orange light.
If you were in the intersection, though, like fully in the intersection, while the light is still yellow, like, that's fine. You're okay. You, you're not entitled to being ticketed. It's only if you are not in the intersection when it turns red and you continue anyway, then it's at fault. It's a, that's running a red.
Free me from this.
Anyway, that thing, if you are in the intersection when it is yellow, it flashes you. It's like, guys, really? Seriously? But the problem though with an electronic ticket is that if you fight it, so if you just pay it, you don't get points on your driving record because it like they can't prove who was driving the vehicle. It just, the ticket is issued to the vehicle itself, not the person driving it, as opposed to like getting pulled over for something. But if you go fight it and you lose, you are admitting that you were the person in the car, and therefore you get points on your license. So it's like, you don't, it's not worth it.
You then, just pay.
Yeah, basically, it's trash. It's trash.
Whoa.
Lego.
Don't shoot at me.
Dude, Legos got violent all of a sudden.
Legos, they're missing out. They got the Call of Duty stuff. They went with Mega Bloks. What were they thinking?
Oh, man. Have you played the new Call of Duty?
I have.
What you think?
It's Call of Duty.
Okay.
Military man shoot. Okay.
I mean, I've just seen, like, I think most of the Call of Duty stuff I see on my feed is from Hutch, and he seems to love it, so that's what I see.
Well, you can never trust him. It's, it really is like Call of Duty in the fact that you'll have moments where you're like, man, this is awesome, everything's going correctly. And then seconds later, you're like, man, I hate this game.
Uh-huh. That seems accurate.
You know how everybody hated Claymores?
Yeah.
Kept Claymores in.
I actually
did. You know
how
everybody hated Bouncing Bettys?
Are there both those things?
They made it. There's a mine that acts just like a Bouncing Betty.
Oh my god. I actually saw a great clip a couple days ago from, what was his name? I think Daquan. And he got...
Yep. I saw that clip.
He got it by like 3 Claymores in 10 seconds. It was pretty amazing.
I believe in that clip he was also using the M4 and the 725, which are considered the two overpowered guns in the game at the moment.
Oh, okay.
I feel no sadness for you. Very.
All right. Well, anyway, that's it for trials. We'll see ya. Have a good day, everybody.